lunchtime Wednesday afternoon, and I just had a little turn around my garden, and I've realized that it's actually really neglected. When we get very sucked in into a particular project, and in my case at the moment it's an allotment, we obviously occasionally forget about what's behind our back door. So I'm hoping to catch up with this tidying up of my back garden and with planting and so on around Easter. I have taken a few days off and I will be able to share it between my now first love, the allotment, and my back garden. In the meantime, please do have a look at fabulous, all-inspiring back garden of Trisha's. It's a multi-purpose space, so it's got something for everyone.
Hello, it's Sunday the 14th of March 2021. I thought I'd introduce you to a little patch of my garden, and going up towards the vegetable garden, which is the most important part, of course. So this is the first level. We're on a hill, as you can see in New Elm, and this is our coffee area and lunch area, actually. And then up to the next level, where China is waiting to greet me. Thank you, China. And here is the summer house where I paint. Such a shame, the sun was shining earlier and it's gone in now and it's about to rain again, I think. This is our evening area. We've just had terrible winds. I've had quite a lot of damage. The olive is over, we're just leaving it over. So this is greenhouse number one. Lots of busyness in here. My propagator with tomatoes, aubergine, peppers, melon, and this poor decapitated cucumber. I've decapitated it with the lid of the propagator, I'm afraid. So he'll have to be redone. Cauliflowers are looking really, really good now. Those are lentils. Didn't have much luck with them last year, but I'm giving them a go again. A few flower seedlings are allowed in here. And we've got courgette, cucumber, tomatoes all pricked out here. Salad leaves and radishes over here. Sweet peas, they're doing quite nicely now. And down here on the next level, I've got my pricked out spinach, two lots of sprouts, and sprouting broccoli. And I've got two little jugs of tap water, because you should only use tap water on seedlings so you don't get damping off. And then around here somewhere, we have other plants which require rainwater. And so carrying on, not too fast, not to make you giddy. We're looking at down on the lawn and the funny old Victorian house and the washing. And over here, as you can see, the wind started up again. The fleece has all been torn that I'm trying to use to warm up the vegetable raised beds. Polytunnel was blown two beds over and landed on top of the peas. I've still got celeriac in the ground here. And here's my soil thermometer, and the soil is still very, very cold. It is not even 1 degree. In fact, it's 0.5 of a degree. So the soil, girls, ladies, everybody, very cold. Now I've got my planting plan here. So I know what's going in each bed. I know what was in the bed the previous year, and so I know what it should follow. For instance, here we had our lentils and runner beans, so that will become potatoes and that family. Broad beans will go follow the brassicas and peas. Over here we have some rather sad but still producing purple sprouting broccoli, and this is the smaller greenhouse in here. And here are the flowers coming on, and yeah, we have got some germination here, a little cosmos, nasturtium I think it is, some cuttings, and finally some green coming up. I sowed those carrots nearly 3 weeks ago and they're finally beginning to germinate. And so this is the onion bed, garlic, shallots, some leeks as well. And coming around the rest of the garden, coming down the other side now, because it was two cottages, so we've got two pots of the garden. Here's our beautiful China dog. And round here, the cherry blossom is coming out. Beautiful, isn't it? And through the archways, we've got how many archways? Four archways, I think. And viburnum out. The roses are all beginning to sprout. And the little tete-a-tete daffs coming out. And a beautiful hyacinth. And this is the exocorda, which is about to flower, and that will be beautiful. It's called the bride. And the contorted hazel, covered in tassels at the moment. And our so-called water feature.